Today, in this tutorial, I want to show you how to make arrays in Blender. And we're also going to use SketchUp and Meshlab to work with our file to prepare it to do all these things. And to start with, I'm going to tell you a little bit about Meshlab, which is a free program just like SketchUp and Blender. This one was developed at the University of Pisa, mostly by a guy named Paolo Signoni, who is a computer graphics scientist, teacher, and it was developed mostly for cultural heritage preservation and some other very lofty goals, but it has also made an immeasurable contribution to our ability to work with 3D files for free, so we should give a lot of credit to them for that. Although, I have to point out that it assumes that you're already a computer graphics scientist, teacher, or a student, so you would know what isoparameterization is and subdivision surfaces and Voronoi vertex clustering. You don't need to know about any of that right now. It's not user-friendly because it's just a list of algorithms, but I'm just going to touch on it very briefly just to show you how you might be able to use it in your work and use it as a bridge between other programs for format conversion and for some other basic operations. So to begin with, I've started with a model here, just a random model. This is actually my foot. I'm really just using it because I have the rights to the model. It's my foot. But what we're going to do with Meshlab here is orient it and position it and scale it for use in SketchUp. And to begin with, I went to the Filters menu in Normals, Curvatures, and Orientation, and down to Translate, Rotate, and Move, Translate, and Center. Turned on Preview, translate center of bounding box to the origin, and hit Apply. All that did is centered it in the view. One important thing here, every time you do some kind of transformation to the model, you're going to have to go to the Normals menu and freeze the current matrix. And that applies that operation to the model permanently. So let's assume that I've positioned and rotated and scaled this object. I'm going to show you one more thing, which you might use fairly often, which is simplifying the model. In the remeshing menu, there's a algorithm called quadric edge collapse decimation. And all that really does is removes the least important, or the edges that have the least influence on the shape of your model. And that way you can preserve the detail, but simplify the model. By default, it will simplify the model 50%. So I just opened the window and hit apply. And you can see that, I'm not sure how well you saw that, but the model now has 50% the number of faces. So it's much less complex. This was originally an STL file. SketchUp doesn't normally work with that. So I'm going to use Meshlab to convert it to a different format. 3D Studio format, the old 3D Studio format. Okay, now I'm going to go back to SketchUp and I'm going to import the file and it will be ready to use.